Roger Penrose, consciousness is the phenomenon whereby the universe's very existence is known.
Well, that's almost a tautology. I mean, if by known you mean known to a conscious observer, then it takes consciousness to bring the universe into the knowledge of consciousness. Of
course. But you know, when we say realists, first of all, are you a dualist or monist?
I'm a complementarian.
Okay, that's good. That's a good way out. Final, I just wanted to say that I recently had a personal communication with Freeman Dyson after a contentious debate with
Freeman's one of my favorite
with
people.
With Richard Dawkins. Right. And as a result of that, he wrote three statements that were beautiful, and I want your reaction to them. The first is, he says, three riddles have puzzled me all my life. The first is the unpredictable movement of atoms. The second is a universe finely tuned for mind and life. And the third is our own consciousness. And then he said, I don't know the answers to these riddles, but I think there's some connection. What do you think?
Well, I think they are very good riddles, and I don't think we've got to the bottom, certainly of the last two. And well, further exploration will tell what the relationships are. I think one thing we've learned, however, from that I can say constructively from our deep investigation of what matter is that it has potentials that you wouldn't have thought, that these strange laws can lead to emergent properties that are just astonishing. And we see that every day, or I feel that every day when I interact with my computer. I mean, here's a lump of matter that does these incredible things.
But
and then I think about other people. If I really believe in what I say I believe in, that their physical, that they can be described as physical objects. What amazing physical objects. What an amazing thing matter is that it can
Hans
do those
Peter
things.
Duer, who was the former director of Max Planck Institute, friend of mine actually, he used to say matter is not made of matter. What do you make of that?
It's a paradox, I don't know. Well, I imagine what he's getting at is that the deepest description of matter that we have is very different than the traditional concept of matter that's of course embedded in the language, if you like. That's
is the mind.
The usual meaning of matter is sort of is extrapolated from everyday experience, and matter of everyday experience is a very different thing than the matter we understand, when our profound understanding of it.